Okay, so in today's class we'll look at we'll solve some more problems on enclosure analysis, on enclosure theory, and one will be on cylinder within a cylinder, concentric cylinders. Basically such problems are involved in insulation design. There's a current carrying wire, and then you have a insulation, and then you have vacuum in between. Okay, it is carrying certain amount of current. So what will be the maximum temperature, or rather we have to work backwards. If this is the maximum temperature which is possible, how much of current can it carry? Like that you design, no, for different thickness, if wires of different thickness, their current carrying capacity is decided accordingly. And the second problem will be a 3-zone enclosure, where we will look at a triangular furnace or triangular duct, where 3 surfaces are maintained at 3 different temperatures, 2 surfaces are maintained at 2 different temperatures, and we have one re-radiating surface. With that we will close our discussion on enclosure analysis for grey diffuse surfaces. Tomorrow's class I will talk about enclosure analysis for diffuse surfaces which are non-gray. Suppose the emissivity of these surfaces varies with lambda, then how do you go about solving this? There are surfaces which are the properties are spectrally dependent, that is they cannot be considered as gray. So we will give an approach, and I will just give one example. From Friday we will start gas radiation that will go on for 4 to 5 classes. Before March 31st, hopefully we will start conduction, and we will have about 10-12 classes max for conduction heat transfer. Let us discuss those aspects of conduction which have not been considered in other courses, alright. Now we will work out this problem, problem number 34. A very long electrical conductor A very long electrical conductor, 10 millimeters in diameter. A very long electrical conductor, 10 millimeters in diameter, is concentric. A very long electrical conductor, 10 millimeters in diameter, is concentric with a cooled cylindrical tube. Is concentric with a cooled cylindrical tube, 50 millimeters in diameter. 50 millimeters in diameter. Whose surface is gray and diffuse? Someone else has your notebook. Okay. With a cooled cylindrical tube, 50 millimeters in diameter, whose surface is diffuse and gray? Whose surface is diffuse and gray? With an emissivity of 0.9. With an emissivity of 0.9. The temperature of 300 Kelvin. Okay. The electrical conductor has a diffuse gray surface. The electrical conductor has a diffuse gray surface with an emissivity of 0.6. The electrical conductor has a diffuse gray surface with an emissivity of 0.6 and dissipates 7 watt. And dissipate 7 watt per meter length, and dissipate 7 watts per meter length, full stop. Assuming that the space between the conductor and the tube is evacuated, assuming that the space between the conductor and the tube is evacuated, determine the surface temperature of the conductor. Determine the surface temperature of the conductor. Is the question clear? We can say that it is an inverse problem, in the sense that we know the heat flux, but we do not know the temperature. What is the story behind trying to find out the temperature? Then we will see whether this fellow can withstand the temperature and all that. Okay, so inverse problems in fact are more practical, okay, are more practical from an engineer's perspective rather than the direct problem. Many times we have to infer, we know some information about something, but we do not know what caused that behavior, okay. So that is why inverse problems are very important. Now you cannot straight away solve this without first writing the radiosity relations and getting the formula. So a good practice would be, hang on, don't start working or don't put epsilon sigma t to the power of 4 epsilon 1 n. I would advise that you keep it as surface 1 and surface 2 with areas A1 and A2. Start with view factors, write the, it's after all a two surface enclosure, write expressions for J1 and J2, get an expression for Q1. Now in a very intelligent way, we can call these two areas as A1 and A2, so that suppose in the exam I ask a problem where there is a sphere within a sphere, this A1 by A2 can be put as 4 pi R1 squared by 4 pi R2 squared. Now this A is 2 pi R1 divided by 2 pi R1 into 1 or L divided by 2 pi R2 into L2, okay. So you keep it as A1 and A2. Now you can see that it will take 15 or 20 minutes for us to get through this algebra, is very, very painful. Already we saw the parallel plate formula itself, I did so many things, right, epsilon 1 sigma t to the power of 4 minus epsilon, I divided by epsilon 1 epsilon 2 throughout and all that. Apart from all this epsilon 1 epsilon 2 confusion, we will have the A1 by A2 confusion here, okay. So there is ample scope for you to make mistakes, take a minus as plus and put A2 by A1 instead of A1 by A2 and so on. So you will have to do it slowly and carefully, and we will get the expressions for J1, J2 and Q1, and then substitute the values, it will be straightforward, alright. So let us start. Get the view factors first, F11 good 0, F12 1, correct. So first write out the view factor matrix. Okay. So part A is over, first part is over. Now we will write the radiosity relations. Now it is a two surface enclosure, the conductor is surface 1 and the tube is surface 2, it is evacuated in between. So we have to write two radiosity equations. You can write down it is a two surface enclosure, so we will get the J1 and J2. I am already incorporating the view factors, okay. Right. Now it is just a question of solving two equations in two unknowns. Straightforward, but the algebra is somewhat messy, so you have to do it carefully without making mistakes. Conceptually, it is not great. Two equations and two unknowns, everything is known. Any mistake? Which one? T would, which one is not known? Okay, very good. Pawan raised a very important point. T1 is not known. Okay, I am just getting the general expression. Finally, I will write an expression Q12 is equal to sigma T1 to the power of 4, blah blah blah, all that. I will get an expression, in that expression everything will be known except T1. Hopefully I will reach that level stage in another 10 minutes, okay. Now what do we do now? The easiest thing is to substitute for J2 in equation 1 and slowly collect the terms involving J1, put them to the left hand side, solve for J1 and then proceed further to get J2, alright. So I will do this. Now I want to have the full board. Let me use the full board, okay. So J1 what is that, 1 minus, oh 1 minus epsilon 1 is already there, right, correct, epsilon 2, this is correct. Three terms from J2, correct. Soham, what is your problem? It is fine. If there is a problem, you have to tell me because the error will propagate. Is it fine? Okay, now I will have to do some simplification. So, J1 is it taking me anywhere? Which one? No, even before this, Yeah, tell me, what is the problem? Which one? Where is this? No, epsilon 2 sigma is fine, no, this is fine, but I have to do work on this further, right. Yeah, that is better, okay, that is better, right, yeah. So substitute for J1 in equation 2, that is good, okay. That is fine, okay. Now this is equation 2, right, I have not substituted so far. Yeah. Is that fine? Okay. Now J2 into 1 minus Yeah, is this correct first? Yeah, please tell me. Vikram, is it okay? Otherwise, we will not get the solution. Did I leave anything out? Okay, so right side? Right side is epsilon 2. T2 to the power of 4 plus into epsilon 1, correct. Yeah, here I have written correctly. Okay. What about this? 1 minus epsilon 2 square? No. This is different. Fine. 1 epsilon 2 sigma T2 to the power of 4 plus 1 minus epsilon 2, right? Epsilon 2 sigma, that is it, anything else? There are only 2 terms, right? Yeah. How many terms are there totally? 1, 2, 3, 4, correct? So, you have taken 2 terms on the left side and 2 terms on the right side, should be fine. Let us see. Yeah, but once you have this in the exam, you can use it straight away. You do not have to derive it because it is all open notes. Okay. But we better derive it now. Okay. Any hope of simplifying? Possible? Yeah, hang on. I will just finish. So, left side 1 minus, what can we do now? A1 by A2, is that correct? Okay. Is that fine? No, I have not completed. Is it okay? I have just expanded this. You have to just help me in identifying that minus and plus. Minus 1 plus epsilon 2. Minus
epsilon 2
A1 by A2. I am also doing it live along with you, right? Because my solution, I started with J1, Ketan told me, sir, we will start with J2. So, it is possible that I end up, it cups, but let us hope that it works, okay? So, I want to pray to God that some terms must cancel. Are they cancelling out? I do not like the 1 first. 1 goes, okay. We will use the red, 1 should go, okay? This also. Not bad at all, right? Is it correct? Okay, we don't know. So, it is too simplified. Why one term is only epsilon 1, other term is epsilon and epsilon 2, right? Okay. I don't know whether we are falling into a pit or something. It comes out? Okay, fine. No, finally it is simple, I know that. Right side, epsilon plus minus epsilon 1, epsilon 2, A1 by A2, very good. It is very similar to what we got previously, right? Tell me. Okay. Correct. Tell me the denominator. A1 by O2 can be taken outside. Why?
Epsilon 2.
Huh? We can take out, right? Epsilon 1. No, is it okay? No, 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 no. Oh, there is something there. I can't do this. Wait. Let me keep it like this. So, epsilon 2. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. Minus. This is more like it. There is hope now. Okay. This equation 3, is something, man. 3, 4, 3. After all this is just 3. Okay. Can we write J1 by inspection? Should be possible, right? Why? Huh? Then no, where is the hope now?
Substituting in the first equation.
Substituting in equation 1. Yeah, we can get the Q straight away, but that's what. Okay, we'll write this. We can get or okay. Therefore, is that correct? Okay. It was good. That was good, Vikram. Okay. Otherwise, you can find J1 also, right? This is correct. I can't believe this. Is it correct? I am now flying on autopilot. I don't have this in my notes. Let's see. You should be able to see the runway. Okay. So, Q12. I erased the J2. So epsilon 1, epsilon 2,
sigma 2 to the power of 4.
Epsilon 1 A1 by A2.
Sigma T1 power 4. Minus epsilon 1 epsilon 2 A1 by A2. Sigma T1 power 4.
Is correct?
Divided
by Q12. Yeah, epsilon 1 epsilon 2 sigma T1 to the power of 4 plus epsilon 1 epsilon 2 A1 by A2 sigma T1 to the power of 4 minus epsilon 1 epsilon 2 A1 by A2. You are getting epsilon 1 square. Okay. This is epsilon 1 square, isn't it? What am I doing? Epsilon and epsilon, then epsilon 1 squared A1 by A2 sigma fine, minus epsilon 1 square epsilon 2, is it correct? Is it correct? No, no, if you cross multiply, okay, let's see. Epsilon 1 square. Plus by, we will just say dr. Now tell me, what are the things which get cancelled? Huh? Epsilon 1 squared get can, then
second and fifth.
What remains? Ah, it's nice. Now I know I'm getting the answer. Okay, so Q12 1 by, correct? Now what do you want to do? 1 by a good check of this formula is if a1 by a2 equal to 1, it will reduce to the parallel plate formula. Okay, the numerator will be the same, the denominator will be 1 by epsilon 1 plus 1 by epsilon 2 minus 1. So this formula displays asymptotic correctness. Okay, therefore it has to be correct. Now it can be correct. Okay, at least it's not wrong. At it is necessary but not sufficient. But when we get, the whole point is like this, when we have done all our search method algorithm and finally we are trying to minimize, we will not end up with the maximum. I used to say that in the optimization course, like that, when it is such a nice answer, it cannot be wrong. A shabby answer could be possibly incorrect. Okay, now Samarjit, you got this? Okay, now point 2, isn't it? R1 by R2 is point 2. Therefore, 7 by, very good. 7 by correct. Is it correct? 2 pi R1 into L, because that is 7 watts per, no, I get 7 watts per meter length, it is correct, no, I gave 7 watts per meter, that was meter length. Therefore, I had to still have 2 pi r 1, correct? Okay. Now, this is, what is 1 by epsilon 1?
1 per meter length.
No, but this q is in watts per meter square. This q is in watts per meter square. Therefore, this is correct. You go, don't worry about that formula. From this is correct. So, what I gave you, 7 watts per meter length, means I am saying L is 1. I am not saying R1 is 1. R1 is there. Abhishek, is it okay? Now, the 2 pi R1 is correct. Okay. Now, 1 by epsilon 1 is 0.6, epsilon 2 is 0.9. Yeah, T1 equal to. Fine. Can a wire withstand the temperature? All right. It can withstand. Suppose there we get 1343 or something, then we have to check our calculation. What is this 348 is how much? 75 degrees. 75 degrees wire can withstand. Okay, so there is no problem. So, if I give you a concentric spheres, A1 by A2 will be 4 pi R1 square divided by 4 pi R2 square. You can apply this formula for sphere within a sphere also. So, you can see that whenever the view factors are not straightforward, when it involves the R1, R2, the fundamental dimensions, then the analysis becomes little complicated, but towards the end you will get a very simplified answer. Okay. So, we will close our discussion with one more problem where the view factors are pretty straightforward. Is this clear to everybody? Okay. So, you get about 348 Kelvin. Yes. Yeah, use the electrical analogy, use the resistance network, but the resistance network will be very painful if you have more number of surfaces. So, the radio and the advantage I told you is it can be scaled up, 0.1, and 0.2 it can be eminently. It is eminently programmable. We can easily write radiosity equation in the computer, and very powerful techniques like Gauss Seidel technique are available, where simultaneous equations can be solved. So, in mathematicians have developed and engineers have developed good techniques for solving system of linear equations. We exploit that. Okay, fine. Now, 35th problem. Consider a very deep duct. That means it is very deep in the direction perpendicular to the plane of the board. That means it is two dimensional. Consider a very deep duct made of diffuse gray walls. Each of which has a width of 1.5 meters. The temperatures of surfaces 1 and 2 are1200 and 800 Kelvin respectively. The temperatures of surfaces 1 and 2 are 1200 and 800 Kelvin respectively. The corresponding emissivities are 0.4 and 0.6. Surface 3 is completely insulated. And has an emissivity of 0.5. For this two dimensional enclosure, that is for this 2D enclosure A, determine A, determine the net radiation heat transfer from surface 1. determine the net radiation heat transfer from surface 1. B, determine the temperature of the insulated surface 3. B, determine the temperature of the insulated surface 3. And part C, if epsilon 3 is changed, will your results change? What is the answer to part C? Why? Because surface 3 is a re-radiating surface, completely insulated means re-radiate. First draw the figure, all the view factors are very simple, man. It is all 0.5, it is an equilateral triangle. So view factors are straight away obtained, and J3 is also very easily obtained. So though you have a system of 3 equations, you have to solve only for 2, because J3 can be written in terms of J1 and J2. So yeah, this will take about 10 minutes, we will solve it. Okay. Surface 1, surface 2. Okay, this fellow is re-radiating 1200. First, see whether all the conditions written on the board correspond to what has been given in the problem. Correct? Consider a very deep. Yeah. Okay. Consider a very deep triangular duct. Okay. Consider a very deep triangular duct. Oh, the word triangular was missing. Okay. Consider a very deep triangular duct. Okay. Now, right, because it is an equilateral triangle, F11 plus F12 plus F13 equal to 1, F11 is 0, F12 equal to F13, therefore 2 F12 equal to 1, F12 is equal to half, F13 is equal to half. A1 F12 is equal to all the, I do not have to do that if it is equilateral. Okay. Now, J1 please watch this, please look at the board, look at the way I am writing J3. I am saying J3 equal to G3, G3 is the irradiation on the surface 3, it is equal to Fij jj, I equal to 3 here. So F31 J1 plus F32 J2 plus F33 J3, okay, this is not, sorry, this is 0, so this is just 0.5 J1 plus J2. So this is a crucial step in an enclosure involving re-radiating surface. Even if you have n surfaces, you will have to solve for only n minus 1 equations, because for the re-radiating surface, the radiosities can be directly expressed in terms of the radiosities of the other surfaces. So instead of solving 3 simultaneous equations, you have to solve for only 2. Okay, it becomes straightforward now. You can substitute the values. So, wherever J3 is there, you will substitute 0.5 J1 plus 0.5 J2. Here you substitute. So, these 2 equations just become equations in J1 and J2. J3 can be straight away eliminated from the 2 equations. Solve for J1 and J2, get Q1. Because once you have J1 and J2, you can write J3, get Q1 and that is it. And then J3 divided by sigma whole to the power of 0.25 will give you T3. Can you do that? We will have another 8 minutes. So, J1, can you tell me the first term? Epsilon 1 is 0.4. Plus what is this? First term 0.4 into 5.6 into 1200. How much is it? Vikram, can you tell me? First one, first term. Okay. Plus, correct? J2 is equal to epsilon 2 is 0.6. Can you substitute? Tell me that first term. Yeah, please. 13,934.6 plus, is that correct? One minus epsilon was 0.4. Then I multiplied with the view factors and absorbed it. Absorbed them. Is it okay? Did I make a mistake? Shrikant, is it okay? 0.2 and 0.2 are all right. Pradeep, what is your problem?
0.6.
Huh? What? I have multiplied Fij by 1 minus epsilon. Correct? Right. Now. Now you can write the 2 equations in terms of J1 and J2 alone. Okay. Is it right? Is this right?
Yes, sir, that's consistent.
Fine. Then, similarly, J2. Point 3 J1. Okay. So. 1 Yeah, people who already have this simultaneous equation solver can tell me J1 equal to 77 0.9, J2 point 0.9, J3 because it's an equilateral triangle, okay, 0.5 J1 plus. Please see, today we have solved two problems, it has taken 50 minutes. The quiz, there will be three problems for 50 minutes, but you do not have to derive, 1 minus A1 by A2 is already there in the notebook, okay. So, do not underestimate a three surface enclosure or a two surface, even a two surface enclosure. If A1, if it involves self view factors, it will take 20 minutes to 30 minutes if you do not have the formula. A three surface enclosure by the shear because of the algebra, it will take 20 to 30 minutes, okay. Yeah, now Q1 is equal to this, is correct? We got the expression for Q in terms of G1 as well as J1. Yeah, now you can write the expression for Q1. So, what do you get? Q1 watts per meter square. This must be multiplied by 1.5 into 1, is 1.5 meters wide, is not it? Are other people getting the same radiosities? Shrikant, did you get the same radiosities? Ketan, these radiosities are okay. Now, please get T3. We have already seen that J3 is equal to G3. If J3 is equal to G3, I have worked out a formula specifically for the radiosity of a re-radiating surface, which is equivalent to that of a black body at the temperature. So, the radiosity of that surface is independent of its emissivity. We have already proved this mathematically. So, the answer must be between 800 and 1200, any other answer is incorrect. 1010.7. What is this surface doing? This surface is receiving heat from this fellow and is putting it back. So, he has no net radiation heat transfer. What is going out is equal to what is coming in, that is why it is a re-radiating surface. And the answer to the part C is, if the emissivity is changed, it has no bearing, okay. So, the emissivity equal to 0.5 for the surface 3 is superfluous or redundant information which is never used in the calculations. Without that also we can do the calculation. So, the good thing is if you have a re-radiating surface, you do not worry about it, emissivity, okay. So, this T3 is actually called the equilibrium temperature of the re-radiating surface, okay. So, we will stop tomorrow, we will look at the concept of spectral radiosity, what happens when epsilon is a function of lambda. It is a very difficult thing, I will just solve it for the parallel plate formula and we'll solve one problem, and Friday we'll go to gas radiation.